I wrote a paper, and that was also in the 90s, about virtual branding. So and you have to imagine that in those days, every brand had a physical product. But of course, we were at the beginning of internet, and of course, there were brands, companies, only doing stuff online. You had Second Life. Do you know that?
I've heard about that.
That's now Fortnite or whatever, all these games and multiplayer games where you can form teams online. But Second Life was like a virtual reality environment, and you could step into that world. And so there were people selling stuff in that virtual world. Can you imagine? So
only virtual stuff.
Yeah, only virtual stuff. So they make stuff in this virtual world and they're selling this virtual stuff to virtual people. So the first virtual brands were born. So I wrote a paper about that because I thought this is interesting because the world is becoming virtual. If it's not now, then 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. And now you see that the most valuable brands in the world are virtual brands.
Yeah.
Can you pick up Amazon?
No.
Yeah, the box, if they deliver, but it's not Amazon itself. Can you pick up Facebook?
Yeah, or Airbnb.
Yeah? So, what you see, and I wrote about it in the 90s, and all those people were looking at me, nice here.
Well, and how was it a bit, I mean, you had a strong, educated guess that is gonna happen?
It's predicting the future, but you never know. But if you extrapolate, and the more you go into the future, the blurry it becomes, of course, because people don't know how. Of course, we don't know how the future will look like. But if you invent something, you can say, okay, this will be probably the next model. This will probably be the next model. When the first mobile phone was developed, it was a shitty thing like this, very expensive, of course. You could imagine that it would become smaller. And it became so small that it was too small.
Yeah.
And then
they are growing again. Yeah,
because this is the iPhone X. And actually, if you look at the G3, was like this. So it's much more smaller, but it was too small.
Yeah.
People like bigger screens. Yeah. And now the tablet is gone. So first the desktop computers disappeared. I mean, most people have a laptop, right? Only in offices they still use, or when you have a very fast game console or whatever. But the whole tablets, I think it's only a few percent still left on the tablet market because everyone is or using the laptop or the growing mobile phones. So that's, and no one could predict that. Because when the iPad came, this will be the future. Everyone will be walking around with an iPad. Well, you don't walk around with an iPad, right? or another tablet. So you see, it's very hard to predict the future. But what you can see is human behavior. I mean, my core is social neuroscience. And of course, that's behavior related. So, I mean, we still have 10 fingers, right? Two eyes, ears. So that's not going to change. Maybe we can increase our sensory information input by senses. So let's say you have a virtual world, and now you're wearing goggles. Probably it will be lenses in a couple of years, built in, not a piece of plastics. It's with cochlear implants, they're already on the market, so that's not new. So actually you don't see anything anymore. We have deep invasive brain interfaces. So actually we can shuffle around with virtual reality within your brain.
I don't know if it's
no, but so if you talk about predicting the future, that's my prediction that will happen. Yeah, I think that neural facing will be will be common in 30 years. Yeah, for people that can afford it, of course.
Yeah.
And this is a very old discussion about the haves and the have not. Yeah. There are people now that are left out. They cannot build houses or buy houses anymore at places where you can make a lot of money, like San Francisco, or Alto Hotel or whatever. Not everyone can afford computer technology. But if you want a job, within 20, 25 years, people are saying, okay, you want a job? I want you to have this implant and this implant so we can communicate on this level with you. And if you say no, say, who cares? Then we have 10 others who are willing to buy these implants.
interesting. Yeah. So we have to trust also on those implantation companies and.
Well, that's the biggest fear. I mean, you can hack a computer.
Yeah.
This is my biggest warning in my lectures. In the future, people can hack your brain.
Yeah.
And then you don't know what's real or more. Listen, if I put something in your computer, like a folder with information, yeah?
Yeah.
Probably you will know, hey, this is not my folder. Right? Because you have a distinction from your own brain and the other devices where you're surrounded with, like your mobile phone.
Yeah.
If I put a memory trace in your brain, you cannot exist, you cannot make the distinction anymore if it's from yourself or not. You're going to doubt yourself.